I've had a quick question about waiting room setup for Zoom meetings. So if you enable waiting room, your next student, if you have students back-to-back in online lessons, won't be able to enter your room until you let them in, which is really good. It's kind of like knocking on the door and they can sit in the waiting room while you finish your current lesson. Otherwise, you're going to have students popping in all the time. So if you're finding that and getting a bit frustrated by it, then this is what you need to do. First thing is you can't set up the waiting rooms from a live meeting. So this is my live meeting window over here. Over there is where we need to log into Zoom on the web. So we're going to go to zoom.us and we're going to log in. Once you're there, go to settings. Now the setting page is pretty epic, actually. There are so many different settings. So it would be worth just spending a minute or two to go through these and make sure you're happy with these options. Firstly, you want to say here, join before host should be off. And then we're going to scroll down, and it's a fair way down actually from memory. Here, waiting room. So we're going to turn the waiting room on, and it will say your settings have been updated. So that means that if they have the same, if two people have the same link to the same room, then if you've started with one, the next person will have to wait until their turn. So that's a really great tip. Now, another person had a question about breakout rooms, which may be useful if you do groups or you have teachers that meet together and then you want to go and separate into other rooms. So breakout room is in meetings under advanced settings, and you could turn that on here. And it says allow host to split meeting participants into separate smaller rooms, and you can allow host to assign participants to breakout rooms when scheduling as well. Now, this could be really useful for you if you do run a multi-teacher studio and you want to work with breakout rooms, then you could turn that setting on as well. Okay, so I've just started a new meeting and I've actually connected to the same meeting on my phone. And so this is what your student will see. It says, please wait, the meeting host will let you in soon. So I'm going to go now to manage participants here on my main screen, and you can see one person is waiting. So this is my next student. So I can go admit, and then my new student has now arrived, and there I am. Hi. So there's the two me's. Remember, you can switch between views by going to gallery views, and you can get people, you can go side by side as well. So let me close this window. If I make this a bit wider, we can go side by side like that, which is a way that I quite like to work. One of the other things that is good to note as well, just back on the settings too, is that quite oftentimes when you start a new Zoom account, these settings for requiring passwords are turned on by default. So I tend to turn these off. If a student, if I'm giving a student my room ID, then I don't expect them to be needing passwords and things like that. It's just unnecessary. So I tend to turn passwords off. Otherwise, you're going to have students emailing you and saying, what's the password for the room? I can't get in. All that kind of stuff. You don't want any of that hassle. Now, you'll notice that we turned on breakout rooms, and you can see there's a breakout room button here. So let's click that. So you can now see breakout rooms here. So there's only one other participant in the room. Breakout rooms only really work if you have multiple people in rooms. But this is how you could do it. You could assign one participant to any number of rooms, and you can assign that automatically, or you can do it manually, and you can then create breakout rooms. So this is where you can set up your breakout rooms. You can rename breakout rooms, you can determine who's in all of them, and those kinds of things. So it really depends on how you want to work with your teachers if you've got a multi-teacher studio. Quite oftentimes, having them all with their own accounts can be much easier for you to manage. But if there is a reason why perhaps you want to get everyone together, maybe it's a recital planning or a concert planning, you want to get all the kids in one room with all your teachers all together so you can talk to them and then break them off into other rooms, then that is a great reason for using breakout rooms. So that's a really quick overview of a couple of other settings that may be helpful for you as you go on with your online teaching. Hope this has been helpful. If you've got any questions, of course, leave them below, and I look forward to hearing how things are going. Hey guys, if you enjoyed today's video, then please make sure you click to subscribe. And if you're a music teacher looking for help with any aspect of your teaching studio or business, then make sure you check out topmusicpro.com for all our membership details.